Hey guys, welcome to Gamenta. This is Das here. So Gamenta presents top 10 new games of March 2016. Now, spring months used to be dead months for video game releases, but in 2016, things are really picking up. Got a lot of games to talk about. Let's starting off with number 10. Samurai still releasing for PC and Mac, and this is from makers of Mechanarian and Botanario. It's obviously to be direct sequel of Samurai 2, and it's a point-and-click adventure with some incredible art style. This game series is cult following for a reason. It's gorgeous. It's quirky, but it's good. If you like Mechanarian, maybe you should jump onto this. And in number 9, we have Trackmania Turbo, releasing for PC, Xbox and PS4. This is actually the first Trackmania game's hit console since Wii. Trackmania Turbo is gonna feature 200 tracks, multiple different game modes, multiplayer and some super impressive track editor. Trust me, this game is amazing for a track editor. If you don't know what I mean, just go on YouTube and look for Trackmania track, because this is some insane stuff. Unfortunately, the console version aren't gonna have the really cool mods which make this game super special, but we're still looking forward to, because it's crazy ridiculous arcade racing game and we don't get enough of this. So what's better than that? And in number 8, we have EA Sports UFC 2 releasing for Xbox One and PS4. This time around, the wrestlers are crazy, featuring 250 playable characters. Now, what I have been interested that the creative director actually acknowledged that the previous game was totally disappointing, because which is very unpolished in combat and lacked any depth. So they talked about how they are completely working on that. This time around, way more dynamic problems, you can just spam your way around. The general overall combat system and this cool new custom event system generator, where you can kind of make your own headline pay-per-view matches. So the last UFC game was completely disappointed, but we are really hoping that they can turn that around, because it deserves a good game. And in number 7, speaking of sports, we have MLB 2016 The Show, releasing for PS3 and PS4. But sorry baseball fan, cause you better have PlayStation console, cause it is exclusive to this. But this time around, it has updated rosters, new modes, more customization, and very simple streamlined modes for people just grab and play baseball game. So basically, if you like baseball, you have PS4, PS3, you are getting more baseball. And in number 6, we have Adrift, releasing for PC with VR support. This game obviously looks to be insanely VR experience, but whether or not you're playing in VR, it's a story-based style game where you take control of Commander Alex Ashima as he floats around in zero gravity in spaceship. There is 5 different areas, puzzles to solve, lots of story audio lacks to listen to and experience to, but most importantly, oxygen to manage. Because if you run out of oxygen, you die, and you really don't wanna die. So pay attention when you play this game. If you really wanted a game that really gives you the experience about floating around in space, or kind of gives you that stress intention, Adrift might scratch that up, and it looks pretty cool. And in number 5, we have Stardew Valley. Stardew Valley released for PC actually very late February, but we are putting on this list because it's a good game and we wanted to mention this. In Stardew Valley, you inherit your grandfather's farm, little bit of money and some old tools, and you're placing this washed up old farmhouse. It's basically your job to live up to this land, build up a farm, raise lifestyle and generally bring the town to greatness. If it sounds a little bit like Harvest Moon, that's because it is, but there are way more RPG elements here. You get to level up your different skills like farming, crafting, mining. There are very big area to explore here, there's a lot of depth here. But the best part is that it is a great Super Nintendo style game that is sprite based and it looks great. So you haven't jumped onto this, and if you like Harvest Moon style game, we can definitely recommend that. And in number 4, we have Pokken Tournament releasing for Wii U. This is the Pokemon Tournament Fighter Tekken style game that we saw pop up on arcades that everyone's been freaking out about, but now it's finally being released on Wii U. The Wii U version is going to feature online battle featuring rank friendly matchmaking, as well as if you buy the retail version of the game, you got a shadow Mew character called Mewcurd. Some of you might not even know what that means, but don't worry about that. Wii U version features some exclusive fighters like Mew, Bioshock, Garchomp. I'm sure the game is going to be updated for bunch of more, but basically, if you ever wanted to Pokemon fighting game, this is your dream come true. I guess basically, if you think about this Pokemon fighting game, because Pokemons are always fighting. But whatever. And in number 3, we have Black Desert Online. This PC MMORPG is absolutely huge and vast. You can probably tell there's videos from character creator. This game is immensely deep with huge world, a bunch of character customization options, and it looks like a midi MMORPG. This game kind of countered like a next-gen MMO with more advanced systems, graphics, weather systems, player housing options, and you know, maybe it's just a marketing buzzword, but the game does look like seemingly huge, and that's why you are talking about it. If you're wanting to sink your teeth into another MMORPG for a while now, Black Desert Online might be it. And in number 2, get ready to potentially get pissed off, we have Hitman on this list. Now this Hitman has this weird new model because in March for $15, you only get the intro to the game and the first big main level. With that being said, it's a very huge level with multiple missions within it, and since IO Interactive has been doubling up in sandboxing, we are hoping that this is gonna give you a whole lot of gameplay time. Myself personally, time will tell. But still, I'm not sure how I feel about this prescription model, but I know a lot of people aren't into it, but I have spent some time with beta, and just as a regular Hitman game, the gameplay there is really good. If you're not into this whole model, how they're releasing into game, you can probably wait for the end of the year when they will release full game in physical edition. But since I'm a diehard fan of Hitman, I'm probably gonna jump into this, just to see what the deal is. And number 1, Tom Clancy's The Division. Yes. Everybody's favorite shooter game that isn't quite RPG, that isn't quite MMO, and that isn't quite Destiny, but kind of really is. We are really excited about this game just because it is cool. New York City in this game is incredibly well realized. Shooting gameplay is decent, but it has all that loop stuff that is so addicting. And the Dark Zone is really awesome PvP fun. But of course, time will really tell if this game holds up over time. They really provide game stuff that is worth really sinking your teeth into. But regardless, we are going to give it a shot. We like shooting people in this video game. And we like RPG and all. So guys, that was all about the best games releasing in March 2016. There's a lot of games to play. We wanna know which one you guys is most excited about. There are some controversial games on this list. I'm pretty sure a lot of guys have a lot of saying in this comment section. If you did have good time in this video, clicking the like button really helps us a lot to do more videos like this. If it's your first time here, subscribe is a very good idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching this video. We'll see you guys next time right here on GameEnta.